DC News Now is your local election headquarters. A new exclusive poll from DC News Now and our partners at The Hill and Emerson College revealing a shocking turn of events in the Maryland Democratic Senate primary race.
Yeah, Angela Alsobrooks and David Trone are now neck and neck. It shows 42% of voters support Alsobrooks, 41% support Trone. Now 12% of voters remain undecided.
It's a drastic change from the last poll in February. Alsobrooks support increased by 25 points and Trone 9 points. For more on what this poll shows us, our Leonard and Fleming has the details.
This is exactly where Angela Alsobrooks wants to be right now, surging with voters as she started out with very little name recognition. And this after Trone, the wealthy businessman, has spent millions of his own dollars. And now we have a race.
The Democratic primary race for a Senate seat in Maryland is in a dead heat. Prince George's County Executive Angela Alsobrooks is surging into a razor-thin lead, 42% to 41%, against Congressman David Trone. DC News Now caught up with both candidates Thursday as they hit the campaign trail.
I have been in living rooms virtually 7 days a week for the last year. And so we knew that the support was there.
The businessman turned politician Trone has spent nearly $60 million of his own money with campaign ads running for a year. He says the contest was always going to be close.
When I launched this campaign a year ago, I was the underdog. The entire political establishment stacked the deck for their chosen.
The poll also shows 12% undecided voters. Alsobrooks edges out Trone 47 to 44% for where undecided voters lean.
I've had an opportunity even today to talk to a number of voters who had not decided and taking the time to share with them my record. I'm finding that when people hear that many of them are willing to support me.
And a lot of folks forget sometimes that self-funders generally lose because they don't have good ideas and they don't show up. I'm a workhorse. I always show up.
The county executive beats out the congressman with black voters 56% to 28%. Trone has campaigned hard in African-American areas like Alsobrooks' home turf for Prince George's County and Baltimore. But he stumbled in recent weeks when he used a racial slur during his speech on the Hill.
Voters know there's a mistake made and you apologize immediately. And I've been the leader in Congress on criminal justice reform.
Alsobrooks says that the voters will decide if the comment will hurt him with black voters.
I think it does matter what you say. I think your temperament matters. The issue around temperament is very important.
Both candidates have received big name endorsements and are expecting to be leveraging these endorsements going into the final week and final push of the campaign this weekend. Reporting from Landover, Maryland, Leonard N. Fleming, DC News Now, back to you.
All right.